They went in for surgery. They came out with infections. One never made it out alive.
And tonight, dozens of Porter Adventist patients are suing the hospital, claiming surgical equipment not properly cleaned has made their recovery process a nightmare.
Denver 7's Ivan Rodriguez in the studio tonight. You spoke to two women still recovering from infections.
And Shannon, they're among dozens listed in this lawsuit. Last year, the hospital sent a letter to more than 5,000 patients saying they were at risk of contracting hepatitis B, meningitis, E. coli, or even staph because equipment wasn't properly cleaned. Two women I spoke with say their lives took a drastic turn after going into surgery at Porter Adventist.
April 22nd, 2017.
July 10th of 2017.
For both of these women, those dates have been ingrained into their memory. The day they went into surgery at Porter Adventist Hospital.
Trust that you're walking in and you're going to be taken care of, and that's not, your health isn't going to be compromised because of negligence or recklessness.
Luana Kurz said she had to have two surgeries done on her hip. After the second one, she says she noticed something was wrong.
The symptoms began to show about 3 weeks out of my big surgery, and it started with some oozing in my incision. And there was a foul smell, and it was about a yellow-green color.
Kerr says she was given medicine to fight the infection, but nothing seemed to work.
Then I learned that it was even more serious than I had thought. It had gotten into my bones where they broke my pelvis, and it turned into a condition called osteomyelitis.
Both women, along with dozens of others, claim these infections are because of improper sterilization.
Those instruments are sort of like saws, and they have crevices in them, and they have very small areas where tissue and cement and bone can sit. So the instruments have to be very, very carefully cleaned.
David Woodruff, the attorney handling the case, says Porter was fully aware of the issue and did not report it properly.
It all goes up to the very top, to the people in charge of the hospital.
For Kurz, she says she doesn't know if she will ever fully recover, and says the lawsuit is more than just a reimbursement.
This is the body that I have. Like, this has to get me through my life. And so I really do feel like Porter needs to be accountable for the choices that they've made.
Centura Health, the owner of Porter Adventist Hospital, says they do not want to comment on the case in the middle of ongoing litigation. The attorney representing the dozens of former patients says this case could go on for years.
Ivan, thank you.